The hood done took me under, no wonder I'm still chilling in the city with no pit. Steps out on my front porch to check my spot. Bells to the store to get that crooked eye shot. I got to have it in my pot. Bring about two or three cases to the potty. Cheer, don't give me that old school chicken bottle. Don't try to fool, son, I want the cool one. The black can is the one that I'm looking for. Make a stop at your neighborhood liquor store. I save a corner just to pour it down. Know it tastes good to my homies. And it, my G's get thick and we chill like the outsiders. On my front lawn profiling low riders. I hit the moon air boys and they get loose. Reach in my pocket, get out my deuce deuce. Saint I, Saint I.
G-Files. Your mission is to obtain information about the G-Files. Knowledge of its release date is crucial to this organization. You are to do whatever is necessary to carry out this mission. We do know that the first single is Get It Cracking. Accomplices Mack 10, Silk the Shocker, and UGK are reported to have a connection to the G-Files. It has been confirmed that Selly Cell, the artist who brought you It's Going Down Tonight, is coming with 18 heated tracks, available on Sequited Jive Records, compact discs, and cassettes.
It's the Underground King's last album, UGK for life. Rest in peace to Pimp C. And cool dress appearances by A-Po and MJG. Akon, Lil Bootsy, Snoop Dogg, Too Short, Webby and more. UGK for life, in stores now.
Yeah. We in the house. MCA DJ Slip. Half Ounce Productions in the house. Yeah. And right about now, DFC's in the house. My homie Breed's in the house. And they about to kick the flint for me, you know what I'm saying? So get with it. I guess them fools just don't know the deal. Cats get peeled. With the gangsta pace, gold D's in my tray as I hop in your face, boo. Bumping nothing but gangsta beats, and I got the big fat key on the front seat, boo. Better think fast, cause Ace gon' blast. Catch nothing but a hollow point in your rubbing them blind like Stevie Wonder. Got the Mack and it's a fact that the hood done took me under. Down with the funk, so really dope. Robbed it for your cash, then dash from 5-4. Release the safety and the bullets start spitting. You get hit in the chestin', cause ain't no BSing. That's why you always catch the menace in a bulletproof E. And DFC shooting out the sunroof. I guess it's just the way that I feel when caps get peeled. Sure. I guess them fools just don't know the deal when caps get peeled. Sure.
I'd say around 87, 88, I took a trip to Mississippi, which my mother was from. And I had a cousin, older cousin, had a Nova. We would ride around in his Nova, and Run-DMC came over the radio. And I was fascinated, like, damn, what the fuck is that? He was like, oh, you ain't never heard of it? I heard rap music, and then I came back home, and then, you know, I started digging a little more, and then that's when the Mantronics and the
Egyptian Lover,
all that started cracking. We had Spade, Mixmaster Spade, we had Toddy T, and they basically brought to light our gangster rap era. Cause they made parodies off of songs like Freaks Come Out at Night and Big Mouth with Big Butt and Clucks Come Out at Night and shit like that. So they would sell TDK tapes around the neighborhoods. Mm-hmm. So when I came back from Mississippi and Toddy T happened to be from Trag New Park. So he had a song off of Rappin' Duke called The Batarang. Mm-hmm. talking about Daryl Gates and the raids, and you know, since I'm the new nigga in Trag New Park and all that. Like, this some real shit we doing every day. Niggas is slanging, police is raiding, homies is getting killed. So from that era, I got turned on the rap. And from there, you know, I got more inclined about the world of rap music, because then I started hearing other motherfuckers, UTFO. I first hooked up with Chill in junior high school. He was a beatbox. Chill lived across the street from Ren. That's when we first started getting our pictures of Easy and Ren, because we'd be over Chill's house chilling, mm-hmm. and then Easy came out with Boys in the Hood. So it was my idea to go, we gonna be a rap group called Compton's Most Wanted.
Okay.
And then from there, we ran into Lonzo.
Right, the World Class Wrecking Crew.
Yeah.
And he gave you guys your first record deal.
So they knew Chill, and basically we were rappers, so they would put us up on little studio time or whatever. They had a meeting with Lonzo to try to go fuck with Lonzo for something. We just happened to tag along. And we had a demo tape. And I played the demo tape for Lonzo. And Lonzo, you know, his brain got to clicking. He thinking, ooh, Easy in them, NWA, whatever. I got these two young dudes. He like, what's y'all name? I said, we Compton's Most Wanted. So he was like, yeah. Lonzo put us on the Compton compilation. That was my first song. We did a song called Rhymes Too Funky.
Think you can have a list? 1, 2, 3. Drop the smooth to the canvas. It's time to start pumping. Know what I'm saying? Yeah, I got the picture. I can miss the spring. Boy, hold up. The chills on the stage. CMW's like a Hub City Army Brigade.
He introduced us to DJ Slip and Unknown. And Unknown had a label called Techno Hop. He had put out Ice-T's first records, 6 in the Morning. Then he had put out King T's first singles. So he had a little experience with street rap. And from there, we put out a 12-inch called This Is Compton. And Unknown put it out. And that's how Compton's Most Wanted was formed.
I guess I'll watch my back cause niggas jeffin'. Cons hurt this brother put the 187. Who I thought was my homie dropped the dime, so I gotta peel his cap with the nine. Fool, if it's on, then it's on. Fuck it, G, because how the odds are looking, fool, it's either him or me. So I loads up the strap and I step, cause my brain cells are dead and all I think is death. Revenge, yeah, that's what it's all about. See the sucker, take the motherfucker out. Step the fool down with the eye contact. He tried to swing, so I draw on him with the gap. Blast was the sound of one time's murder. Nigga 25, the life for the murder. Was it worth that? I always wonder. Maybe if the hood didn't take me under.
Unknown had us, he had King T, he had Dub C, and he had Ice-T.
Yeah.
And Easy was just an outsider, but now he was putting his hands in the pot. So now you got to deal with actual gang members and Crips and Blood. I knew Ren real good, and I knew Easy. I mean, but as far as dealing with them, I wanted Compton's Most Wanted to have its own identity. I didn't want people to say that we were trying to piggyback off of Easy and Ren and them. Literally. If you listen to our music, we never took the NWA route. Never, okay. You know.
But to be fair, like, I was listening to a bunch of your records. It seemed like there was a lot of Ice Cube samples in the choruses and stuff like that.
Oh, definitely. I mean, we scratched a lot of, because we want to keep our records home-based. Mm. So we scratched a lot of Ice Cube. We scratched a lot of Lynch Mob, a lot of Easy, you know. But I did that to pay homage to dudes I looked up to, sure. You know, because they paved the way. You know, if it wasn't for Easy and Boys in the Hood, who knows what type of music we would be doing right now.
Being able to do Menace to Society, you know, it was always a significant boost to my career to gather, cross over, and get some of them fans from the other side, you know, to have people come view the movie and see what we do in a reality state, you know, as far as growing up in Compton or any rough part of ghetto or poverty-stricken area, you know what I'm saying? So to cross over and do Menace to Society and gain other fans, man, it was always a blessing. You know, it's always good to have something to excel your career from wherever it might have been at the point. So it was good. It was appreciated.
I played a character named A-Wax. Everybody know the G. You shoot him up, bang, bang.
Would settle for the minimum snaps. Have to live in the ghetto where the blacks be at.
It's cool, man. Fuck out of here, man. Your ass out of here. We don't need that shit. Damn.
Hey.
Stand when they do that shit.
Who got some snaps on the Petro? Who got some snaps on the Petro?
I got you tomorrow.
Come on. My motherfucking pop. Y'all niggas hurt. Broke in the motherfucking slanging all that shit in the hood, and y'all ain't got no motherfucking money.
We'll get you, man.
Fucking pump my shit.
Peace.
All that motherfucking money. Hey, wake up, Nick. $3. Fool.
Like, if they said to me, hey, you know, if you feel that a real G wouldn't do that, or if you feel a real G wouldn't act or say that, then don't do it and put your own in there. So basically, you know, I would ad-lib most of the parts, you know. Most of it was written, and I could relate to it because coming from Tiger and Alan and Albert and them
Hughes
coming
brothers,
from
the directors of the movie.
Coming from them and being from LA or whatever and them seeing the situation of how it was here in Compton and Watts, you know, it was cool and the lines were straight up, you know, it wasn't no corniness. So to me, it was basically a good feel about the movie because it wasn't nothing stereotype about it. I got another group called Compton for Life, which is a dude named Lil Hawk and Bird. They'll be coming out on also Big Beat Atlantic, you know, breaking with 8 High Productions. And you'll be on the look for the new Compton's Most Wanted album coming out on Epic, you know, in a couple of months. The name of that is called We Come Strapped.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Win the house for the 94 shot.
94.
8 Hypes in the house.
Right.
And right about now, half ups in the house.
Bounce, right.
NOTRs in the house.
Right.
Lil Hawk and Bird.
Yeah, they got the back.
The foe. You know
yeah,
what I'm saying?
Yeah, I hear you.
Just call me the come up kid.
Come
hard times kicking it in the CPT. So that means I gotta do what I gotta do. And if you ain't down with the hype, we gon' dump on you. You're coming up short when we ski. So when we hit your corner, you're gonna be a gonna nigga duck. When my nine starts to buck, in it for the snap, so I'm crazy as a. I should be laying low, cause one times it's real high. Need to make a nod, so I brush your spot. And it's like that when I got the feeling. If you don't kill, somebody else does the killing. So when you hit the end of the road, ain't no turning back. I done signed the hood, lifetime contract. Yep, jacking and packing, cause ain't nothing funny. I guess it's all for the money.
When Face and them came to LA, you know, I knew Scarface because I was a fan of the Ghetto Boys, man. After we had connected, you know, doing, you know, interviews and just being on the road, bumping into each other, they would come to LA all the time. I picked them up from the airport, rolled by the spot, ran inside, grabbed a pistol because I knew we was going to be riding around because I wanted to take them around to the spots and shit like that. And at that time, Compton was still a place where, you know, the gang activity was still high. Everybody had pistols.
Some bitches. I got some motherfucking money. Fucking with them.
What's up, nigga? What the fuck you tripping for?
Give me my money, nigga. Come on, quick.
Nigga, fuck that and fuck you.
Punk, I ain't playing with you, nigga. Break yourself.
Bitch.
Nigga.
Motherfucker. Bitch ass, nigga. Motherfuckers! Squeak! Damn!
all coming at your door. You start to scream out loud, Wu-Tang's back for more. Yes, the hour's four, I told you before. Prepare for mic drops and bust the Cold War.
Hey man, check out that 6-4.
Yes, this shit is raw coming at your door. You start to scream out loud, Wu-Tang's back for more. Yes, the hour's four, I told you before. Prepare for mic fight and bust the Cold War.
What up, nigga?
Aw, damn, what up, Grandma?
Tell your daddy to pay me.
All right, then. All right, player, stay up.
Peace.
Yes, the shit is raw coming at your door. You start to scream out loud, Wu-Tang's back for more. Yes, the hour's four, I told you before. Prepare for mic.
Around with a gun every day now because of the situations that I had to deal with when I used to gangbang and the brothers who won't let you live that shit down. Me being a rapper, I'm basically just giving you the real. I seen everything. So that's what makes me speak like I speak, and that's what makes me bring the music like I do, because I've been there. You know, I belong to gangs. I done went on drive-bys. So it just all has to depend on the situation, you know. If somebody threatens you, you gon' kill him.
I hit the pedal, then I jet. Duck in my leg, bucking, I'm bucking back, cause I ain't dead yet. Now it's time to take me home. And I'm lying on my back, spitting up blood, and I'm thinking to my sissy. No more living in the life that's she. Straight thugging it up. Somebody say, come on. Somebody say, yeah. Somebody say, we straight thugging it up.
That's right.
Somebody come, say, come. Somebody
West
say,
side.
Somebody say, yeah. We straight thugging it up. Come on. Straight thugging it up. Come on. Yeah. Straight thugging it up. Come on. Yeah.
Tell my homies, rest in peace. Shit.
Well, you live where I live, and if you just black, period. Like they say, it's a routine. A black man in a fancy car, you're gonna get pulled over. You're gonna ask to step out your car. You're gonna get your car searched. No probable cause, no reason, no whatever. It just happened.
This nigga balling like a motherfucker.
Chicken Hawk would love to hit this nigga.
Yeah.
Okay, what the fuck we doing up here with these niggas, homie? We don't need these niggas. We could have did this shit ourselves. Nigga, fuck these punks.
Nigga, fuck you, nigga.
Nigga, fuck you, nigga. Get out where you get mad at.
Drop your bitch ass right now, nigga. That's on me.
Come on, nigga. Come on, let's get this motherfucking paper, man. Come on, we here together, man. Y'all niggas need to be on point for these niggas.
This nigga Gator got paper, dog. He's supposed to be a cool nigga, but... fuck that nigga, he even think about trying to jack a nigga.
Blow his motherfucking noodles out his head. Y'all niggas need to think about this shit.
Lines, are you sure these niggas cool?
Everything straight, man.
One minute we trying to kill these niggas, now we chilling.
Fuck these niggas. Let's get this motherfucking paper, man. Stop tripping. Damn, look at all this shit. Look like some Scarface shit or something. Damn.
I'm cooking.
DJ, I need to holler at you, though.
Hey, girl, what the fuck out the way?
Hey, nigga, hold up. I don't think you're gonna find us this shit right here, nigga.
Hey, we mother take that.
Nigga, you ain't gotta do shit but die, nigga.
Then get you a boss.
Fuck that nigga, man. Well, you fucking find that.
Gator, Cali niggas are strapped.
Look, I ain't asking you why. Gator. I'm asking you how, goddammit. What?
Said they strapped.
So what? I'll be wondering about if they wasn't. Y'all chill on that.
Hey, Rock, talking to this motherfucker some money missing from that last pickup, and I want to know where it went. Don't get off this motherfucker till you find out, you hear me?
Yeah.
Sorry about that, Flash. Niggas think when you get large, you stop paying attention. I keep my eyes on the paper, even them tools and fuse. Which one of y'all's DJ?
DJ, I'm...
All right, now?
My dog, Lazo.
Lazo?
Y'all take these fellas on in there. Make them comfortable. DJ, you and your partner. Y'all come on back in. Holla at
me. Scravy?
Y'all straight, though.
California, huh?
Yeah. You got it all laid out like a player, huh?
I do what I can, player.
That's right.
Look at this shit, man. How can anybody get mad when y'all got all this to look at?
Don't let the sunshine fool you, homeboy.
See, you got to look beneath it.
I hear you. Shit, I've been wearing all white ever since I've been out here. So I didn't know what gang was what color out here. Nah, it ain't like that, dog. Niggas know who down with who.
Ain't like that in New Orleans. Niggas shoot you because he in a bad mood. Everybody think we all about parties and Mardi Gras. Like, we all stupid out here. Some kind of joke or something. I like for people to think I'm stupid in country. Because that's when I beat them.
No. I like y'all players. Y'all like me.
I had to grow up with nothing. My daddy ain't had nothing. So he ain't had no opportunities. Nowadays, you got some balls, some baking soda, you can be a rich man. So how rich y'all players want to be?
I want to be rich as a motherfucker.
Nigga, we want to be about $100,000 worth rich.
I knew I liked y'all. All about getting y'all's, huh?
That's all it is to be about. Getting yours. When can we get them things?
Hold up, player. First, I got to lay something on y'all. Two things. This here fucked up business, straight up. One minute you Tony Montana and the world is yours. Next minute you looking at your baby mama through a glass, talking to her on telephone. So look here. If I get caught up, y'all names don't come out my mouth. Y'all get caught up, my names don't come out your mouth, you hear me?
Shit, I ain't got a problem with that.
That's how the game go, homie. We ain't no bitches. We ain't no snitches.
All right, then. Let's get paid.
I don't want my kids to grow up in the environment I grew up in. So I moved out. You know, I sent my kids to the good schools away from the fucked up shit because I didn't have that opportunity. When I was a youth, I didn't have no choice. I had nowhere else to go. I had to stay there. But I know what I did to get here, and all them nights I spent in the studio rapping and writing, and it was all me. And you try to help some of your homies out. I hook niggas up, you know, if you know how to rap, I try to get you a deal. I work with you in the studio. But it's not a form of just going, okay, I got paper, here go 1,000, here go 2,000, here go 5. And that's what brothers expected. You have to learn who your true homies are and shit. You got the jealous homies that don't want to see you come up. You got the player haters. You got the crooked females who want to set you up. And then you got the niggas in general who just roll around just looking for niggas, period, to jack. I don't put my city down. I love Compton to the fullest. But with me being a father, a businessman, me staying in Compton would mean me having to deal with the same situations as I dealt with as a teenager. I moved out to the community where I could walk out my front door and wouldn't have to see gang writing and shit like that because I lived in that shit all my life. And I figure if you can, you might as well to better yourself and to better your future family.
Evil, boom, book, duck your head instead. The scene that is left, is your death. Yeah. It goes up, the fools wanna beat me, but them wicked fools don't wanna see.
Come on. It was one situation where me and, you know, the Quik thing was going on, and it was a lot of back and forth because, like, I was a dude who still hung out in Compton. Suge pulled up on me one day while I was, you know, by mom's house, and he told me to pull over, and, you know, a couple of dudes walked up on my car. And he just wanted to tell me, you know, as far as the situation that was going down with me and Quik, with coming from Easy and Dr. Dre and NWA, and then the follow up with, you know, Compton's Most Wanted, and then you got MC8, now you got Dj Quik, and then what happens, you know, to follow from behind that. But then there's a transition from, you know, from the time you start walking home from school and niggas is asking you where you from and you getting into fist fights and shit because you don't know what the fuck is going on. Like, what life is this?
Yeah. Yeah. 1-2-1-2. We came in the door, said it before. We came in the door, said it before. West side, east side, when we hit the floor. Got the paper, the show got green galore. And the homies be begging us to blow some more. With me, I'm on the premium, never on the regular. Connects inbound trips on my cellular. I'm telling ya, must be the good life, son. Land of the sunshine, crystal wine. Keeps one time, thinking suspicious. S5-26, chrome 20 inches. Must be the money from the rhyme. They don't know, must be the money from the gang for sure.
I used to go to Chicago a lot. Around the time of my second to fourth album, I used to do a lot in Chicago. I basically was in Chicago probably every weekend doing concerts for the GDs.
I'm finna go live with one of my family members from LA in 89. The nigga told on her on some gunplay, but y'all gonna hear from her words. I ain't gonna say shit else. I'm gonna let her tell y'all herself.
The same way you went and found some paperwork, man, dealing with MC8. How you gonna say call MC8 a rat? And then in the same breath, you gonna talk about Free Nate and Free Jimmy?
They mad, G, because I'm reading Nate's book, and Nate, you know, pull a skirt up on the bitch MC8. The nigga in the hood with us, remember?
That nigga trying to testify on them people.
Come on, man.
So I got real familiar with the GDs.
You the one that linked yourself with Jimmy D. You the one that's all on these videos talking about Free Jimmy D. So if you linking yourself with Jimmy D, I'm showing you, hey, homie, you might want to unlink yourself with him.
No doubt.
Y'all talk all this goof-ass shit. Y'all mad y'all can't catch no skeletons in my closet.
At the time, I was really close with a lot of dudes from Chicago.
God damn it, stood 10 toes down.
You knew this, boy. You knew that this dude, Jimmy D, was a rat. Don't tell me that you ain't know this here.
I ain't gonna say it. What case was y'all on, G?
Dude case.
Big homie. Free Larry Bernard motherfucking Hoover, man.
They were throwing this big concert in Milwaukee. It was a big concert. Ghetto Boys, Escape, Spice, me, just Tupac. It was a big ass concert. You know, a lot of dudes had traveled up from Chicago up to Milwaukee because it's nowhere. It's, you know, hop, skip, and a jump.
All right, first clue. Something you write with.
A marker.
A marker.
Motherfucker, you don't be writing with no marker, motherfucker. Smaller, nigga.
A pen.
All right, cool. The shit is working. All right, second clue. Oh, this is easy. Shit, what we be dumping on them mark-ass G's with?
And that offended a lot of niggas in the audience, you get me? Because a lot of these niggas are from Chicago, you get me? And a lot of them, I'm talking about, it's probably 100 niggas there up from Chicago.
Come on.
Shia.
Hey.
Now
power. Once with a gang that Hoo Bangs for fame and cross town robberies. Know the nickname. Leave them dead in they shoes. Serve them the stray blues. G's that pack tools. Pay dues is the rules, but it's cool. They dumps, then I dumps backs. Me and my G's in a 6-4 flag, laying a flag. Rat a tat tat from the gatin. We represent y'all, hit the bricks when a pistol spit.
I don't know, the pistol came out, there was a shot in the air, and then next thing you know, dudes start hopping on stage like, there was about 100 GDs in my dressing room because, you know, they felt really offended. So I was trying to calm the scene down. I had to stand up on the table because, like I said, it was about 100 niggas in my dressing room. So we got escorted out, and it looked like the whole city of downtown Milwaukee. It was just a million people just running around. We got banned from going to Milwaukee for a long time.
Hello?
Hey, wake up, homie. This Mack.
What's up, 1-0?
Dog, meet me down the street. It's on out here.
Yeah.
Get up.
All right, I'm about to get up right now.
Oh, Hoo Bangin, homie. Get up for real. All
right, for sure.
Man, where Dre stand, man? We're going to be late for work, man.
Late? Man, we're going to be late, T. We own the shop, baby.
Man, I just like to be on time, homie.
Oh, he come right now. Oh.
Hey, what about this one though? Remember this? Check this out.
That's why water be dripping. What the fuck you talking about? Water be dripping. Nigga, penguin, pen gun, and shit sound the same to me.
Nigga, that shit don't count, nigga.
And I've had so many cats over my course of the years to tell me, man, I went and did this off of Hood Took Me Under. I went and did this off of Drive By Miss Daisy. I went and did this off of because you had that soundtrack. And that was the reason why I called Music to Drive By, Music to Drive By.
Y'all know these real OGs got blocks to squeeze. You know the outcome. Flips off the hard. One time, flip the script, get your backyard. Know the real deal. Undercover spots to chill. Know the enemy creep, best pack to steal. I ain't knowing what I trick for dope. If I knew what I know now, would've caught the f. Know your game plan slow, f the rest for sure. Know the West number one, tell your bitch to blow. Y'all know these rag wearing pants sagging niggas with you. Know your upper class bitches love a thug. Know your days is done. Know you won't be the blaze one. Know when the raise. Know I bash or run. Know your talk is cheap. Know I'm in too deep. Know if you test the West, then you put to sleep. Cheer.
The hood is mine, homie. Chips I stack.
The hood is mine, homie.
Get back.
The hood is mine. The hood is mine.
Yo, this is Trill OG, Bun B, letting you know the Trillest album of the year. Trill OG is in stores August 3rd, featuring Young Jeezy, Drake, Tupac, Pimp C, T-Pain, and many more. Trill OG in stores August 3rd. Keep it trill.